What do we humans need to survive? Well, we need food, oxygen, water, and living space. All those things are normal for us, but did you know that there are organisms living on Earth right now that don't need the same things we need to survive? These organisms live in places like this one. That would be terrible for us, but perfect for them. Because they live in such extreme conditions, scientists call them extremophiles. Extreme! Well, not like that. Let's refocus. But what exactly is an extremophile?
So an extremophile is an organism that can thrive in extreme environments. And what I mean by that, it's environments that you or I would find to be very inhospitable or hostile to what we need in order for us to thrive. So an example is an organism that would live in extremely warm or extremely cold temperatures. And that could be an organism in Antarctica. It could be organisms that are thriving in the middle of a desert that's extremely hot with lots of sunlight. There are many extreme environments that would be damaging to us as humans, but there are microorganisms that just love living there. So we study extremophiles because they tell us the limits to life here on Earth. And it turns out that almost every possible environment on Earth has an organism living in it. So one of the most interesting extreme environments that I've learned about is environments that have very low pH. So we typically live in an environment where the pH is somewhere around 7. That's called neutral pH. Some organisms can live in pHs all the way to 0, really acidic. And just for perspective, battery acid that comes out of the batteries in your car are pH of 1. Soda is actually pH of about 2. If we were to try to live in a can of soda, our bodies would start to dissolve because low pH or acid will break apart our skin. But an organism, a microorganism, can actually live at that pH. It can get nutrition from the soda as well as survive that very low pH environment.
Who knew these microscopic and often very creepy looking organisms could give us so much information and mean so much to NASA? Curious as to where we can find these extremophiles? Tune in for part 2 on Our World.